Tonight, at the same event that rocketed Barack Obama into the national spotlight in 2007, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg will try to capture some of the same magic. A new poll out of Iowa shows that he has a good start. Buttigieg is polling at 18%, sharing the top tier with Senators Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders, and also former Vice President Joe Biden. But as CNN's Jeff Zeleny reports from Des Moines, there's still plenty of work for Buttigieg to do.
Change that America can believe in.
At this point in that presidential campaign, this 46-year-old senator from Illinois was still an underdog, well behind Hillary Clinton, but slowly starting to catch fire. This year, the youngest candidate in the race is also on the move.
Are you ready to leave behind the reality show in Washington and change the channel to something we can all be proud of?
It's too soon to know if Pete Buttigieg will follow the rise of Barack Obama. But he's turning some of the same heads in Iowa, like Terry and John Hale.
So does he remind you of Senator Obama?
Absolutely. It's the intelligence. It's that cool composure. It's the ability to be presidential.
Pete is catching on. The more people that see him, the more people that support him.
It was 12 years ago when Obama's long-shot candidacy turned a corner here, dazzling thousands of Democrats at the state party's fall gala. This time, the Hales are among many Obama admirers now on the Buttigieg bandwagon.
Pete and Obama both had a certain amount of pragmatism to them.
At a recent rally, Terry Hale introduced the South Bend mayor.
Right now, Mayor Pete Buttigieg!
And she said she felt like she did in 2007.
The energy and the excitement and the positivity and the hope, that's what I feel at events for Pete. And I have not felt that since Barack Obama.
Buttigieg was also watching that race closely, volunteering for Obama in the final days of the Iowa contest.
It's what's going on the ground and what kind of relationships you're forming that serve you well when the caucus day actually rolls around.
No two campaigns or candidates are the same, yet both men represent a fresh face and are calling for change.
I believe that we need a new generation of leadership to step forward.
Same old Washington textbook campaigns just won't do in this election.
The Buttigieg campaign is embracing the comparisons, trying to use its $23 million cash on hand and momentum in the polls to build a modern-day Obama-like operation. Tommy Vitor, part of Obama's original Iowa team, says the burden is now on Buttigieg to meet these expectations.
Barack Obama came up as a grassroots organizer, and I think that made the whole campaign sort of make sense and flow from him, but like it still remains to be seen if that's going to deliver on caucus day.
And that, of course, is the challenge facing the Buttigieg campaign here, Brianna. You can see behind me a lot of supporters are gathering here. There's a van, there's a bus. They are gearing up for that dinner tonight. I can tell you, after covering the Obama campaign, the campaigns seem very similar. The energies, the crowd seem similar. The candidates, of course, very different, and it is a very different time. But, Brianna, there are so many Obama alumni working on the Buttigieg campaign. Many of them hope the same outcome here in 3 months. Of course, the voters will decide that. Brianna?
Well, the poll is very interesting. Jeff Zeleny in Des Moines, thank you for that report. Jen Psaki, you worked, obviously, for former President Obama. Is this a fair comparison?
You know, I think Democrats historically have loved kind of intellectual, smart, young, charismatic figures. Barack Obama was one. You could argue Bill Clinton was one. And Pete Buttigieg certainly is one as well. And I think what the similarity is, there are a couple similarities, but one of them I would point to is that when people go see him and they learn more about him and they hear him speak and watch his interviews, a lot of Democrats like what they have to see. So for him, the encouraging number in some of the polls is that two-thirds of Democrats in the Iowa caucus poll are willing to look at other options. He's already high in the polls, but I think his hope is to do what Barack Obama did, do what John Kerry also did, which is to kind of make a move when there's an opening. And there always is an opening in the Iowa caucus in the final months.
Let's look at the poll. Brand new Iowa poll out. Warren, Sanders, Buttigieg, and Biden all there. And, you know, Chris, it seems like you look at that and you say, okay, Warren, Sanders, Biden, Buttigieg.
Yeah,
this is the thing we're keeping our eye on.
The
right
fact
now.
I keep coming back to and reminding people is Joe Biden spent 8 years as the Vice President of the United States, 30 plus years in the Senate, and has been the front runner effectively since the day he got into this race. He has less than $9 million in the bank. Pete Buttigieg, who is the South Bend, Indiana mayor, has $23 million in the bank. I mean, that in and of itself, that stat is mind-blowing. This poll, I think, I'm with Jen. I think if you look at this, you're thrilled if you're Pete Buttigieg, not necessarily because you're in that top tier, though that's certainly helpful, but because if you're not already for, certainly, Sanders or Biden, these are known commodities. I mean, Biden has been around forever. Sanders ran last time. If you're not for them now, what's the message that convinces you to be for them? Whereas with Buttigieg, if you look at that poll, Biden, Warren, Sanders, all very well known by voters. Buttigieg, much less known. That's great for him. He's got the money to spend to sell what is a pretty compelling life story up to this point.
Why do you think he's doing so well, Sungmin?
Well, I think there's a number of reasons, but I keep coming back to how he's been able to kind of really contrast himself with the front runners and kind of punch up if necessary without turning off a lot of the voters. I mean, I keep thinking back to the moment where Julian Castro went after Biden in one of the debates with a pretty not so subtle dig at his age, and that really was a liability for him. But, you know, Buttigieg has been able to focus it a little bit more on policy. He really went after Warren hard in the, I believe, in the last debate over the Medicare issue, which I know we'll talk about later, and that actually he was seen as doing very well in that debate. I think what he's trying to do now is kind of seize sort of the Biden lane, if you will, in terms of ideology and policy, but with the fresh face added. And we see with the former vice president's decline in the polls, I think that's a lane that if Buttigieg does well, that he could really capture.
So we've seen him, one of his struggles, though, Bill, is African-American voters. He does pretty dismally with them. So you're seeing him do well in Iowa, but in an October Monmouth University poll, he had 3% support in South Carolina, where there are many African-American voters, and it's essential that he appeal to this voting bloc. What would happen there if, say, he had a strong performance in Iowa?
I think they would take a look at him. I think most of them don't have no idea who he is. I don't think they have anything against him particularly. He's just not been fighting for the causes they care about the way Biden has for decades, and to some degree Warren and Sanders, they would have some knowledge of some issues that they've been prominent on. So I think the key for Buttigieg is Iowa, Iowa, Iowa. He needs to be top three. If he were top two, that would be even better. If he won, that would be even better. And then it can really take off. I mean, these are extremely dynamic. The primary process, when you have a multi-candidate field narrowing to a small field, we've seen this many times, that's when it's its most dynamic. That's when Iowa just is a slingshot. And Gary Hart goes from being second in Iowa to winning New Hampshire, to almost beating Mondale, who was a prohibitive favorite that year. So once John Glenn, who was an early favorite, he totally collapsed. So that could be a sort of analogy to Biden and Warren. So I take Buttigieg seriously. I do not believe he's going to run a good race, but of course he's not really going to win. He could win.